Welcome students in lecture number 3 of polyphase AC circuit of unit number 4. Today I am going to complete concept of 3-phase supply, phase sequence, balanced and unbalanced load, voltages, currents and power relations in 3-phase balanced star connected loads and delta connected loads along with phasor diagrams. Now this is an example of generation of single phase voltage. In the animation, a single coil is rotating in the magnetic field. When it cuts the magnetic lines of forces, EMF get induced in the coil, and that EMF, the nature of that EMF is sinusoidal. Depending upon the positions of the coil, it is reaching the voltages at different levels. So this is a single system. Now polyphase system means, poly means many, phases means windings or circuits. So whenever in the system the circuits are more than one, then it is known as polyphase system. So universally 3-phase system is adopted because it has some advantages over the single phase system. So three-phase system, armature is divided into three coils or three windings. They generates equal voltages, but they are having phase difference of 120 degrees. Now what is mean by phase difference and why the phase difference is 120 degrees? Now phase difference is equal to rotation angle divided by number of phases. Now the one rotation is equal to 360 degrees. So 360 divided by the number of phases. Number of phases in our case is 3. Hence the phase difference is 120 degree. So in 3-phase systems, all the 3 voltages are having same magnitude, but they are 120 degrees phase shift apart. So in our diagram, there are 3 coils or 3 windings. One coil is R coil, another coil is Y coil, and the third coil is B coil. All the 3 coils are mounted on the same shaft. The dimensions of all the coils are same. These coils are rotating anti-clockwise direction in the magnetic field, and they cuts the magnetic lines of forces, due to which EMF get induced in the circuit. So if I consider R as a reference phase, then the EMF induced in the R winding or R phase is Vr max sin theta. Then the Vy is 120 degrees phase shift apart from Vr, hence Vy is equal to sin theta minus 120 degree. So Ey follows Er. Then Eb is at again 120 degrees from Y. So Vb is equal to Vb max sin theta minus 240 degrees. So here we are representing it in terms of waveforms. So in case of Ey, it will attain its maximum or minimum position 120 degree later than Er, and Eb will attain its maximum and minimum position 120 degree later than Ey. So all the coils together represent the 3-phase supply system. If we add these 3 voltages vectorally, then the sum of these voltages is equal to 0. That is Vr plus Vy plus Vb is equal to 0 at any instant. Now I am showing these voltages in terms of phasor diagram. So while drawing the phasor diagram, we are considering first the reference voltage Vr. So I am drawing Vr. While drawing the phasor diagrams, the voltages should be having RMS values. Hence here the Vr is the maximum value. Hence I am converting that value into RMS value. That is Vr is equal to Vr max upon root 2. Then Vy is at 120 degrees from R. So here Vy, and Vb is also 120 degrees from Vy, hence here is Vb. So this is the phasor representation of all the 3 phases. Now this is an example of three-phase generator feeding a three-phase load. Now this three-phase load can be a three-phase induction motor or three-phase transformer. Now these are the interconnections of three-phase system. The three-phase systems are interconnected with each other. If we use these three phases separately, then the system becomes very complex. So to reduce that complexity, we are interconnecting three phases. So there are two types of interconnection. One is known as star connection, or it is also known as Y connection or delta connection. So in the star connection, if you see in the diagram, in star connection, either all in terminals or starting terminals are connected together to make a common point, which is known as neutral. So in the star connection, three phase three wire and three phase four wire systems are possible. In the three phase three wire system, the output wires are three, R, Y and B. And in case of three phase four wire system, the four output wires are there, R, Y, B and neutral. So this diagram is example of three phase four wire star connected system. Now in case of delta connection, in delta connection, starting terminal of one winding is connected to end of the another winding and making a closed loop. This is known as delta connection. In delta connection, only the three phase three wire system is possible because there is no neutral in delta. Now these are some concepts which are related to three phase system. A balanced three-phase supply. A supply is balanced when all the three voltages have the same magnitude but differ in phase by 120 degree with respect to one another. The three-phase supply system is unbalanced even if one of the above conditions is not satisfied. Now this is no balanced load. The three-phase load is said to be balanced when magnitude of all impedances are equal in magnitude as well as phase angles and of the same nature. Now what is mean by the same nature? If the impedance is inductive, then all the three impedances should be inductive. If it is capacitive, then it should be capacitive. If it is resistive, then all the three impedances should be resistive. So this is the example of star connected balanced load. This is an example of delta connected balanced load. So this Z is what? Impedance. This impedance can be any circuit, RL circuit or RC circuit or RLC circuit or purely R, purely C or purely L. But all the windings should have the same circuit. Unbalanced load. A three-phase load is said to be unbalanced when the magnitude as well as phase angles are different from each other as well as they are having different in nature. For example, in this diagram, three-phase unbalanced star connected load, the one winding is resistive, another is inductive and third one is capacitive. So this is the example of three-phase unbalanced load. Now the concept of line voltages. The potential difference between any two lines of supply is called as line voltages. Now take the example of three phase supply. In this three phase supply, there are three lines R, Y and B. So the voltage between R and Y is VRY, voltage between Y and B is VYB and voltage between B and R is VBR. These are the line voltages and the system is symmetrical or balanced system, hence all the voltages are same. Then line current. Current passing through any line is known as line current. So in this case, the current flowing through R line is IR, Y line is IY and B line is IB. Now the concept of phase voltage. Now for phase voltage, I am considering a three phase load. This is the load. Now what is the phase voltage? The voltage between or voltage across any branch of the three phase load or three phase winding. So here is VR is the voltage across R winding, VY is voltage across Y winding, and VB is voltage across B winding. So VR, VY and VB, these are the phase voltages. The system is balanced systems, hence all the three voltages are same. Phase voltage, then for phase current, the current passing through any branch of the three phase load is known as phase current. So phase currents are here, IR is coming from the supply and the same IR is going to the windings. So in star connection, the phase and line currents are same. So IL is equal to IR equal to IY is equal to IB. Now the same concept we are applying for delta connection also. For delta connection, again, in case of delta, there is no neutral connection. Hence, the line voltage and phase voltages are same. So in delta, VRY, VYB, VBR is equal to VL, which is equal to V phase. In case of delta, line currents are IR, IY and IB. Now the same current is not flowing through the phases because here IR is dividing into two parts. Here IY is dividing and here IB is dividing. So the current which is flowing through R winding is IRY. Current flowing through Y winding is IYB. And current flowing through B winding is IBR. So these are the concepts of line current, line voltages, phase current and phase voltages. Now consider a three phase star connected resistive load. Now this Z phase 1 is the resistive load. Now if I apply the KVL to this circuit, my VRY is equal to VR plus VY. Here I am considering the neutral connection, then VRY is equal to VRN plus VNY. But we are following VYB, hence this is minus VY. I am reversing. Hence VRY is equal to VR minus VY. The same VYB is equal to VY minus VB. VBR is equal to VB minus VR. So by using these three phasor equations, we have to draw the phasor diagram. So while drawing the phasor diagram, first we have to consider a phase voltage as a reference. So first we have to draw a phase voltage VR. So for simplicity, we have to first draw a circle and then show the radius, up to the radius of the circle VR. Then at 120 degrees you draw VY up to the radius of the circle. Then VB again up to the radius of the circle, because VR, VY and VB, they are same in magnitude because the system is balanced system. Now the equation is VRY is equal to VR minus VY. So here I am extending VY in opposite direction, that is minus VY. Then I am using parallelogram, that is drawing the parallel lines from VR and VY. I am getting the resultant as VRY. Now I want to show the currents. The loads are resistive load, hence the currents are in phase with the voltages. So here VR is in, IR is in phase with VR, IY is phase with VY and IB is in phase with VB. Now in this particular case, the connection is star connection. So the question is, prove that in the star connection, line voltage is root 3 times phase voltage and line current is equal to phase current. So for that we are considering this phasor diagram again, and we are drawing a perpendicular bisector from point A. Now this is a triangle OAC In the triangle OAC, OA and AC are same, hence here is the bisection of angles between minus Vy and Vr. So here I am considering the angle AOB is equal to 30 degrees and I am writing cos 30. Cos 30 is equal to adjacent upon hypotenuse, so it is OB upon Vr. Now OB is half of the OC and that is the line voltage. So here I am substituting OB is equal to Vr cos 30. The value of cos 30 is equal to root 3 by 2. Okay, so here we get the answer as VL is equal to root 3 V phase. In star connection, line voltage is root 3 times phase voltage. This derivation carries 6 marks and this is a very, very important derivation. Now if in the this derivation can be asked in three ways for three different loads. First case, resistive load. Now in the second case, if the three phase star connected inductive load is given, then the phasor diagram is same, only the Z phase is replaced by RL circuit. Phasor diagram is also same, only the positions of the currents changes. For example, in inductive load, current lag voltage by some angle phi. So here only we have to show the currents which are lagging currents. Rest of the derivation is same. Similarly, if in the derivation the load is capacitive load, then again the phasor equations are same, phasor diagram is also same, only the positions of the this Z phase is different, that is RC, and the positions of the currents are different, that is current in capacitive load, current leads voltage by some angle. So the one derivation, phasor diagram same, only the positions of the currents are different depending upon the load. Now this is three phase delta connected load. In delta connected load also there is a relation, that is line current is root 3 times phase current and line and phase voltages are same. So for this we are considering the delta connection. Now I am applying Kirchhoff's current law to the node R. Okay, so at the node R, IR current is entering, IBR is also entering and IRY is leaving the node. Okay, hence the equation is IR plus IBR minus IRY equal to 0. So if I rearrange the equations, then IR is equal to IRY minus IBR. The same thing is for Y node. For the Y node, IRY is entering, IYB is leaving the node. Okay, and IY is also entering the node, hence IY is equal to IYB minus IRY. The same thing is here for node B. So IB is equal to IBR minus IYB. So for drawing the phasor diagram of delta connected load, we have to consider current phasor equations. Again, the same thing, first we have to draw phase voltages VRY, VYB and VBR. Then the load is a resistive load, so we have to show the currents. In resistive load, current and voltages are in phase, hence draw IRY in phase with VRY, IYB in phase with VYB and IBR in phase with VBR. Now the first phasor equation, that is IR is equal to IRY minus IBR. So here I am extending IBR in the opposite side and the resultant is IRY. Now for proving relation, that is IL is root 3 times I phase. Here also I am drawing a perpendicular bisector from point A on OC. OC is the line current. So in the triangle AOB, again I am writing cos 30 is equal to adjacent upon hypotenuse, so OB upon IRY. Now OB is half of the line current, that is IR upon 2. IRY is the phase current and cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So IL is root 3 times I phase. So in delta connected load, line current is root 3 times phase current. Line voltage is equal to phase voltages. Now the same thing, the derivation can be asked in three different ways, like for resistive load, for inductive load, for capacitive load. So for inductive load, again the phasor equations are same, derivation is also same, only the position of the currents are different. That is, current is lagging the voltage. So draw the currents IRY, IYB, IBR. Take equal angles of all the currents. Let us say 20 degrees or 30 degrees. Then consider the first equation, IR is equal to IRY minus IBR. So I am extending IBR. Again the same, I am completing the parallelogram and the resultant is IR. The rest of the things are same. Similarly for the capacitive load, again the phasor equations are same, only the position of the currents. Current leads the voltage by some angle, and here also we have to consider the equation and complete the phasor diagram. Now these are the power related with star and delta connection. Now consider here power for three phase voltages. Now for single phase voltage, what is the power? V phase I phase into cos phi. Now the system is three phase system, so what is the power? Power is equal to 3 into V phase I phase cos of phi. Now the system is star connected, so phase voltage is equal to VL upon root 3, because we are expressing powers or any rating in line currents or line voltages. Hence we are converting this power in terms of line voltage and line current. So here P is equal to root 3 VL IL cos. This is the active power or real or true power. Then similarly for reactive power, Q is equal to root 3 VLIL sin phi. Unit is var. And S is the apparent power, which is root 3 VLIL. Its unit is volt ampere. Similarly for delta connection also, we have to consider a three phase power, that is 3 is equal 3 into V phase I phase cos of phi. In this case the IL is root 3 times I phase, hence power is equal to 3 VL IL upon root 3 cos phi. So power is equal to root 3 VL IL cos phi. Q is root 3 VL IL sin phi and S is equal to root 3 VL IL volt ampere. Now this is the application. This is a three phase load, this is three phase induction motor, and this is a single phase load, that is bulb, which required 230 volt. This three phase motor required three phases. So input of these three phases are R, Y and P. And for the bulb, you can consider any of the line and the neutral. Now the numerical. A balanced star connected load of 8 plus J6 ohm per phase is connected to a 3 phase 440 volt supply. Find the line current. Now in the problem, impedance of the circuit or load is nothing but the impedance of the winding is given, 8 plus J6, and the voltage supply is given 3 phase 440 volt. So for solving this problem, first we have to write the given data. The connection is star connection. Then the The voltage which is given in the numerical is always the line voltage if it is not specified. So here VL is equal to 440 volt. Then the connection is star connection. In the star connection, line voltage is root 3 times phase voltage. Hence I am converting this V phase line voltage into phase voltage. That is, V phase is equal to VL upon root 3. Then the Z phase, that is the load, is given 8 plus J6. 8 plus G6 means it is a type of RL load. So I am converting this into polar form, because for the division purpose we required polar form. Then I phase is equal to V phase upon Z phase. Okay, so dividing the magnitudes and subtracting the angles, hence the answer is I phase 25.403. This is a phase current. The star connection is star connection. Hence line and phase currents are same. Hence IL is equal to 25.403. Another example. Three coils each of 5 ohm resistance and 6 ohm inductive reactance are connected in delta across 3 phase 440 volt 50 hertz supply. Calculate current drawn, power factor and power consumed by the circuit. 5 ohm resistance and 6 ohm inductive reactance is given. Inductive reactance, the notation is XL. So impedance of the circuit is 5 plus J6. System is 3 phase system. 440 volt 50 hertz is given. This 440 volt is the line voltage. Okay, so given data, Z phase is equal to 5 plus J6. Then I am converting it into polar form. Then the line voltage is 440 volt. As the connection is delta connection, phase and line voltages are same, which is 440 volt. Then phase current is equal to V phase upon Z phase. So I phase is 56.33. Now in the delta connection, line current is root 3 times phase current. Hence IL is equal to root 3 into I phase. So the answer is 97.58 ampere. Now for power factor, power factor is cos phi, and this phi is angle of impedance, that is 50.19. so cos of 50.19 is equal to 0.64. now this lagging leading is depends upon the type of load. Here the impedance is 5 plus J6, that means it is RL circuit, and in RL circuit current lags voltage, hence here power factor is also lagging. Now power consumed by the circuit, that is the active power, P is equal to root 3 VL IL cos phi. So the answer is 47.60 kilowatt. Now next example, a balanced 3 star connected load is supplied from symmetrical 3 phase 400 volt 50 hertz system. The current in each phase is 30 ampere and lags 30 degree behind the phase voltage. That means the phase current is given here 30 at an angle of lagging current, so 30 at an angle of minus 30 is given. Again, the voltage 400 volt, that is the line voltage, is given. We have to find out phase voltage, resistance and reactance per phase, load inductance per phase and total power consumed by the circuit. Here the Z phase is not given, we have to calculate that. So first we have to write connection is star connection, frequency is 50 hertz, line voltage is 440 volts. Phase current lags phase voltage by 930 degrees. Okay, so V phase, first we have to calculate the V phase. Relation is V phase is equal to VL upon root 3. Then I phase is also given, that is 30 at an angle of minus 30. Why minus 30? Because it is lagging the voltage. Hence I phase is 30 at an angle of minus 30. So Z phase is equal to V phase upon I phase. So here the value of Z phase is in the polar form, I am converting into rectangular form. So if I compare this equation, Z phase is equal to R plus J XL. So R is 6.667 and XL is 3.849. Now for finding inductance, XL is inductive reactance, which is equal to 2 pi FL. So L is equal to 12.25 milli Henry. Again, the power consumed by the circuit is equal to root 3 VL IL cos phi. So answer is 18 watt. So here we have completed the unit number 4. I already completed transformer in my previous videos, and in this video I have completed polyphase circuit theory as well as numericals. Now these are some most likely asked questions, theory questions. So first question is, state the advantage of three phase system over the single phase system. Then define symmetrical system, phase sequence, balanced load, unbalanced load. Derive the relation between line and phase values of currents and voltages for balanced three phase star connected inductive load connected across the three phase AC supply. So this derivation can be asked in three ways, either inductive load, capacitive load or resistive load. Phasor equations are same, only in the circuit diagram Z phase are different, and in the phasor diagram the position of the currents are different. Then derive the relation between line and phase values of currents and voltages for balanced three phase star connected inductive load connected across three phase AC supply. This is delta connected. Delta connected for inductive, resistive or capacitive load. So here we have completed our fourth unit. Now you go through these videos and study. If you have any doubt, you can contact us. Thank you.